obviously we talked about Tank Davis and stuff, but you know, this guy was ranked high. Yeah. What is kind of your next? Are you looking at a top five guy, or like what's kind of your decision?
Just keep growing each fight and getting a better opposition every fight, and just, you know, growing. You know, one day, at one moment, I'll become, you know, a man. I have my man strength, and then I think that's when everything will click. And, you know, I feel still a little small against those guys. So, you know, everything will click. I just gotta trust in God and just see, because obviously He put me in this position for a reason. So I just have to trust in Him and see what He got in store for me.
I know you said you felt fatigued in the beginning. Last time you kind of put it on the body shots that, you know, that you wanted to work more on. That, yeah. Was there anything this time that you feel that maybe you could improve on?
I just should stick to the game plan. Don't go back, because whenever I pressed him forward, he really couldn't do anything. He really wasn't landing no punches, and I was controlling the pace, what I want to do. So just stick to the game plan, you know, keep moving forward. Don't let him push you back. He can't fight going back. So I should probably just stick to the game plan a little bit more.
You guys were friendly in the beginning, obviously afterwards.
Yeah.
Same respect, all
that's
that.
My guy. Me and him are cool, so I have no problems with him. He came to fight. I mean, you look at, he was busted up, he's cut on his nose, cut on his eye. It wasn't actually 100%, but I really did catch him with a hard hook, split his eye. Then I caught him with a jab, split his nose. So I had him leaking. But he came to fight, like I said, he's a player of the heart, like a champion. Like, not a lot of people would, like, take all that punishment and keep fighting. So,
my last question, what was it? I mean, this, the whole environment seems like,
insane.
You know, tailor-made for you. The
insane.
Facebook thing, I mean, you came out to the, you know, your guy. Tell us about all that and the fun you had.
Bro, I like to say, I'm 20 years old. I'm not even supposed to be doing this. That's why it's a blessing. Haters can talk all they want. At 20 years old, what were you doing? Like, I'm living my life. I'm living my dream. So say whatever you want. I'm gonna keep improving, and I'm just gonna feel like I'm gonna get better and better each time. So honestly, I'm just enjoying life.
One more question.
Hey, well done. Thank
anybody else?
Ryan, speaking of haters, there's people that kind of talk smack about you because of
always.
Your level of position, but at the same time, they talk smack about you when you call out big fighters.
Yeah.
So what? How do you respond to that, especially since you can never really keep them happy?
So what? It's a sport where you have to. You know, entertain, you have to start controversy. You can only, like, your promotion can only promote you so much. You have to go out there and you have to, you know, make a name for yourself, whether it's good or bad. Like, honestly, just go out there and speak your piece and take the good with the good, the bad with the bad. I know I got loving fans regardless. Like, you see, everybody still loves me no matter what. Like, I can fight anywhere and people will come. So, I'm happy.
Thank you. Thanks, Ryan.
Thank you.
Thank you.